वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू फ्रेंड्स. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट प्लांट टिश्यूज. वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड अबाउट प्लांट टिश्यूज इन अ प्रीवियस वीडियोज एंड नोट्स. वी हैव सीन दैट प्लांट टिश्यूज दे आर बेसिकली ऑफ टू टाइप्स, मेरिस्टमैटिक एंड परमानेंट टिश्यूज. ओके, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यूज. नाउ अंडर परमानेंट टिश्यू वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट सिंपल परमानेंट टिश्यू एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यूज. We have also studied about under simple permanent tissues parenchyma, colenchyma. Okay, now today we will study about sclerenchyma and we will differentiate between colenchyma and sclerenchyma. So simple permanent tissues are such types of tissues which are made up of only one type of cells. Now they are of three types, that is parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Now parenchyma nodes and colenchyma nodes I have already given you. Let us compare how they are, these two are different from that of sclerenchyma. Now let us, today's topic is sclerenchyma. Okay, so let us see the third type of simple permanent tissue, that is sclerenchyma. Now this sclerenchyma, if you compare the diagram of colenchyma and sclerenchyma, then you will see that in case of sclerenchyma, the cell wall of the cells, they are thickened, okay, but not at the corners but uniformly throughout. This is because of deposition of this, the thickening of the cell wall is because the deposition of lignin. Okay, lignin is a type of carbohydrate, so they are known as lignified thick wall. Okay, so these walls are lignified thick walls. And here some openings you can see. These openings are called pit, P-I-T. Okay, so pits. These pits, they allow the movement of substances in between the two cells. So substances can move in between the two cells, adjacent cells. So this is the diagram of sclerenchyma type of tissue. Now this sclerenchyma type of tissue, they are made up of dead cells. Okay, dead cells. So usually they do not have nucleus or protoplasm. At a certain time the nucleus and protoplasm, they become dead, and the walls of this sclerenchyma, they become lignified, they become very thick, thickened, and they are known as lignified cell walls. But pits are present. Through the help of these pits, substances can move in between the adjacent cells. Now these cells, they are basically very thick, okay, uniformly, and they are dead during maturity. Some examples of such kind of part in the plant body where sclerenchymatous tissues are present are in the veins of the leaves, okay, in the stem. Then when you eat guava, you have seen the sheets of guava, they are very hard, so that is made up of stony substance, that is called sclerenchymatous tissue. Then the husk of coconut, it is very hard and stiff. That is also because of lignified cell walls. That means sclerenchymatous tissues are present. Also the gritty substance in pear, P-E-A-R. When you eat a pear, you know, if you can feel the gritty substance, that is also because of sclerenchymatous tissues. Okay. So the difference between sclerenchyma and colenchyma is that in case of sclerenchyma, the walls are uniformly thickened. But in case of colenchyma, the walls are basically thickened at the corners. See these walls, orange shaped. So these walls are thickened at the corners because of the deposition of cellulose basically and some pectin. But here these wall deposition are because of lignin. So they are called lignified. That is the basic difference between colenchyma tissue and sclerenchyma tissue. Also in case of colenchyma tissue, the lumen is much more wide. So lumen, where the you can say vacuoles or the cavity, cell cavity is very very wide. But in case of sclerenchyma, the cell cavity becomes narrow slowly. Okay, at maturity this will completely be covered. I will show you the diagram. This will be completely covered. So this orange portion, that means lignin, will completely cover, and the lumen will be as small as this, or sometimes it will not at all be there. Okay, so intercellular spaces are usually absent because the cells are, they are very much close to each other. But in case of colenchyma, very little or no intercellular spaces are present. Mind you, parenchyma cells are living in nature, but sclerenchymatous tissues are dead in nature. So these are some of the major differences. Okay, parenchyma tissue helps in maintaining the flexibility of the stem. That means it helps in easy bending. Suppose there is wind and the branch or the twig, they will bend, but they will not break. That is because of parenchyma tissue. But in case of sclerenchyma, it is present in the wood. Okay, the hard wood of the trees. They are having lignified walls. So these are some of the basic differences between parenchyma and sclerenchyma. Okay, so please go through these notes and write the differences also in among these three types of simple permanent tissue, that is parenchyma, parenchyma and sclerenchyma. Now let us see some real life pictures. That is, so if you can see this diagram, these are the deposition of cellulose at the corners of the cell. So this is parenchyma tissue, okay, parenchyma tissue, but this is sclerenchyma tissue. This one is sclerenchyma tissue. See, at first nucleus is present in some of them, but at during maturity, see, the lumen is completely filled and the nucleus usually is degenerated. Okay, so these are sclerenchymatous tissue or sclerenchyma, whereas the previous one is, this one is of parenchyma, where you can see the cells are thickened at the corners. Okay, intercellular spaces are here also absent, very little may be present. This type of tissue is present in the stem or in the leaves, tendril stems, leaves. Okay, whereas sclerenchyma tissue is present in the you can say nuts or sheets or hard substance like the coir of coconut, okay, the outer covering of coconut, or some hard stems like in a case of brown stems, that means mature stems, or they can be present in the mid veins of the leaves, etc. So their function is to provide mechanical support and to give rigidity and stiffness to various parts of the plant's body, like it is present in the, you can say, nuts and sheets, etc. Okay, like the walnut, the covering of walnut, that consists of sclerenchyma tissues. But parenchyma is present in the stems, okay, tender stems or leaves, where it also gives mechanical support, but it helps in easy bending of the part of the plant. So these are the differences between parenchyma and sclerenchyma. Okay, so parenchyma means they are glued together, whereas sclerenchyma is very hard and gritty type of substance that gives protection and mechanical you can say support, or it gives rigidity and stiffness to different parts of the plant's body. Okay, so please read the note, go through them, learn them and write them in your class of copies. Thank you so much for watching this video.